Hello, this is Leech 83. How we doing? Welcome to episode 8 of our Celtic career mode here on FIFA 17. In today's episode, we've got a away trip to St Johnstone, followed by a tough game against Benfica, and then we'll finish off the episode at home to Inverness Cali Thistle. So, should be a good start to November, hopefully, if we can get the right results. But first of all, obviously, we do have the St Johnstone game, and let's get into that right away. So, we're going to be playing in our usual 4-1-2-1-2 formation with Nyland in goals, with Gamboa, Samnovovic, Savyachenko and Izaguirre completing the defence. Then in the midfield we've got Sinclair, Arthur, Burke and Armstrong, with two strikers up front, Rashford and Lee Griffiths. So let's get into it. Arthur to Rashford, to Armstrong, to Scott Sinclair, early chance by the post. Corner for us. Sinclair delivers it, front post, header, and it's into the back of the net, and that's going to be Stuart Armstrong with the header, front post, good one, good delivery, and that'll do nicely. Good one, I say, he's standing still. He's there, and it's in the back of the net. That's all that matters. 1-0. That's a good ball out wide. 81 minutes played, St Johnstone on the attack. Now we can counter-attack. Griffiths looking for Alex Iwobi. It's a bit wide, I don't know if I'd like it, but that's fine. Iwobi, chance to deliver. Cross not dealt with. It's a poor attempted clearance. And it's Savyachenko running up the park and getting very, very fortunate from that one, but I'll take it. And it is 2-0. Well, not the best of games all round, but it's the 3 points that matter. We had the most chances again and slightly edged the possession. 12 shots, 6 of them on target, 51% possession. And we played not too bad, to be fair. And we deserved our victory, as I say, 2-0. So that was ideal, and we're keeping up our performances in the league. Now we turn our attention to the Champions League, and we'll play our next game against Benfica. So we'll get the team ready for that, and I'll come back to you with the lineups. Right, so we're just about to get ready to get into the game against Benfica, and here is the table down the bottom corner just now. As you can see, Spurs top with 9 points, we are second on 4, and then Napoli with 2, Benfica with 1, which is us in a decent position at the moment, even after that poor result against Spurs in the last game in the Champions League. If we can get something from this one, with just a couple of games left to play, it puts us in a very good spot, so a lot to be played for, that's for sure. So let's get into this game then, and we will be picking our usual green and white hoops, and this is the team. It's Nyland in goals with Lustig, Touré, Savyachenko and Izaguirre at the back. We've then got Sinclair, Brown, Robertson, Forrest in the middle, with Rashford and Lee Griffiths completing the lineup. So let's get into this game, let's see if we can get something out of it. Touré wrong footed, there's a chance for Benfica. It's Rafa inside the box. Rafa can't finish. Rashford popping that through for Sinclair. Back to Rashford. Chance to come in. He's got Forrest. Back to Rashford. That'll do. That's 1-0. That's lovely play. Created and finished by Marcus Rashford. Outstanding play. Come inside. Forrest held it up well. Good little turning pass and good finish. Oh, that's poor. And this is Jimenez. It's Jimenez with a chance to get a last minute. Ah, he's got it back. And it's going to be Jonas. Not Samaras. Andreas Samaras has got the goal back for Benfica right at the death. Jimenez playing it back across. Nyland caught out. And it's 1-1. Well, disappointed in the end to lose that goal right at the last kind of minute in injury time, which is kind of how it goes. Benfica edging the possession, but we had just kind of edged the shots. We had 7-2 on target, they had 6-2 on target. And as I say, they had slightly better possession than what we had. But to be honest with you, it was not too bad a game in fullness. Benfica probably deserved something out of it, to be fair. It was just one of those ones I'm just disappointed that it came at the time that it did. but that's just the way that it goes sometimes in football. But we'll take the point. Let's just click on advanced here and see what happened in the other game, which would have been between Spurs and Napoli. Spurs have won that game 2-1, which gives us a definite boost. We'll be on 5 points, which pretty much guarantees us into the last 16. I'll double check the group. Let's just get a quick look and see where you can get the groups here. Right, I believe it's in this part somewhere. There's an easier way of getting this. I know there is. It might not be in this. Maybe not, but other leagues. Whereabouts do you get it? I know you can get it. The bound tables. Scottish Prem, Scottish Cup, European International Cup. That was our pre-season. There's our Champions Cup, right? So we are Group E. There we are. So there we go. We are on 5 points. Napoli on 2. Benfica on 2. With 2 games left to play. So no, we're not quite there yet. We're almost there. If we can get something from the next game against Napoli, then that gives us confirmation of going through. So at least a draw against Napoli, and we're guaranteed the last 16. So not all doom and gloom, plenty of football to be played. And we'll get the team ready then, and we'll get into our last game of the episode, which is going to be against Inverness Caledonian. Okay, so here we are ready to get into the game against Inverness then, and this is our lineup. We've got Gordon in goals with Gamboa, Simnovovic and Savyachenko, and Tierney confirming the defence. And then in the midfield, we've got Sinclair, Brown, Roberts and Nakamura coming in. And then we've got Rashford and Lee Griffiths up front once again. So let's get into this one. Let's continue our good league form and get another 3 points. Nakamura hopping over the tackle, finding Griffiths. Griffiths for a shot off the post. But it's air for Rashford. That'll do nicely. Didn't think we were going to get the luck there, but we did. Came back off the post. Fell straight to Marcus Rashford. And he was able to tuck it in eventually. Wasn't the best of goals, but I'll take it. Good play originally. Griffiths rattle on the post. And Roberts, Rashford from a tight angle, making it 1-0. Nakamura. Through ball for Lee Griffiths, taking him out wide. Back to Nakamura! Oh, Shinsuke Nakamura. Started, finished. Lovely. Need to change his number, mate. I thought I'd done that. I need to change his number to 25. Perfect finish. That'll do nicely. Free kick opportunity, and it is Shinsuke Nakamura that's going to take it. Let's see if we can get something on target with the Japanese maestro. Oh, that's went in. I don't know how it's not, how the keeper's not got that. The keeper should have got that. It's Nakamura flown it over, and the goalkeeper's absolutely shite. It's went into the back of the net, and it's 3-0. Nakamura, nice little flick for Griffiths to Rashford. Play back to Nakamura on his hat trick. Oh, that'll do perfectly. The Japanese maestro getting his hat trick. Doesn't play very often in a team, but when he does, he makes an impact, and he sure has in this game. That is it. It's game over, and Shinsuke Nakamura picks up the match ball. It's a 4-0 victory. 3 shots, 3 goals for the Japanese maestro, and that's absolutely perfect result for us. A 4-0 victory, which is really, really good. 9 shots, 6 of them in target. Inverness not really threatening in front of goal, having 4 shots, none of them on target. They did have the possession, but to be honest with you, at one stage I was just happy to let them have the ball, as they weren't really doing anything with it. So I can take that, and I can take that result as well. A 2-0 victory for Aberdeen against them, and that is ideal, because obviously we're going to win the title. I think the fight for second is not as tight as what anybody would expect it to be. We'll just have a little look at the table and we'll just see where we are. So we're on 33 points. Aberdeen are 5 points behind on 28, and then 10 points behind us is them. And then back to Kilmarnock in 4th with 17 points. Disappointing to see where Hearts are. Look, Hearts are down in 6th place. Motherwell, Ross County and Inverness making up the bottom 3. So, not too unrealistic. Obviously, Kilmarnock's position, Partick Thistle's position, not really true, but still generally right. So ideal. That's a decent performance for us in this episode, that's for sure. And we are now into the start of November. We've got Aberdeen in our next game, followed by Napoli, where if we get a point in that one, that will give us football in the last 16. And then we've got Hamilton Accies, which will be our last game of the next episode. So make sure you come and tune in for that. If you're new to the series, then check out the links in the description, which will take you to the series playlist, and you can check that out. I'll have also put a wee eye somewhere in the video as well, so you can have a wee look for that. If you've seen it already, you probably clicked it. But anyway, hope you enjoyed the video. If you do, any feedback, as always, good or bad, please let me know in the comments section. That's what they're there for. And any of your feedback will make these videos better in the future, that's for sure. I still find myself getting nervous when I do these fucking things at times. But at the end of the day, if I can just do this, it's just a wee hobby. So if somebody watches it and you're right all the way to the end and you're still here, then I really do appreciate your support. Hail, hail, and I will catch you in the next one. You take it easy.